Cathedral on North Street in Kingston, the Holy Trinity Cathedral, the liturgical celebration in thanksgiving for life of two martyrs, Brother Shuris Bauer and Brother Marco Candelario Las Puna, both of whom died and departed this earth on October 27th and October 28th, respectively. Brother Shuris Bauer died on the 27th October from gunshot wounds, and Brother Marco Candelario Las Puna succumbed to his injuries a day after, on the 28th October 2005. Today, the ceremony and celebration and thanksgiving for the life of these two martyrs is at the Holy Trinity Cathedral on North Street in Kingston, following a private interment at the Corpus Christi Monastery of Missionaries of the Poor. Right now, we are experiencing tributes which are being presented by members of the Missionaries of the Poor and other outstanding personalities just ahead of the liturgical mass. The chief celebrant in the mass.
And now we call on the Father, Mr. Mauricio Las Puna, to give his tribute on behalf of his son.
The next tribute comes from Brother Marco Candelero Las Puna's father.
Oh, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to Christ Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Father God in heaven, you are the God Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. You are the God who has more than enough. You are the great provider. Lord, for whatever I have done, please forgive us, Lord, the sins that we have committed, that we have committed a sin, so thoughts in words and in deed. Cleanse us, our hearts and minds, through blood of Jesus. In order, I have the right to praise you, adore you, and thank you every day, all of my life. Lord, even though events are contrary to our wishes, please, I still express in behalf of my family, please, our heartfelt thanks and gratitude to all the people who supported us, provide us everything that never happened in my life. Lord, thank you for this. You are so great, oh God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, for the death of Shuris and Marco, this is just the beginning. This is just the ending of the beginning. Their life on earth, the first journey in life in earth. The second journey is they are now entering the new home, the kingdom of God, the kingdom of Jesus Christ, a home of everlasting life. God, make the two of them, Shuris and Marco, my son, be an instrument to be your new guardian angel, to guide us, to guide their co-brothers who are still trying to dedicate their body and soul in their vocation or profession. Give them strength and power in order that they could convince others to join the congregation and more people to be converted. For this happened to them. So, Lord, I ask this, everything that I have in this heart, I ask this to Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
The father of Marco Candelario Las Punian, missionary of the poor, who was born on the 2nd of February 1974, and who departed this earth
Thank
on the
28th
October Douglas, 2005.
Mr. and Mrs. Las Punia, we now call on one of our residents, our homeless poor, Owen Thompson from Faith Center, to come and offer his tribute. So we welcome Owen Thompson.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. On behalf of all the residents of the Missionaries of the Poor who have received great love and care and selfless and dedicated service from our beloved brothers, we want to say a special thank you. Brother Suresh and Brother Marco served us joyfully and with great patience. We admire them. We say to them now as we salute them, Brother Suresh and Brother Marco, we love you. This song we offer is a tribute on behalf of all the residents to our two dear brother martyrs.
Fountain,
washes our tears all the way. Words are swaying, someone is praying, please let us come home to stay. Dreams will never die. Dreams see us through to forever, where clouds roll by for you and I. When we are out there in the dark, we'll dream about the sun. In the dark, we'll feel the light. Warm our hearts, everyone. If we hold on together, I know our dreams will never die. Dreams see us through to forever, as high as souls can fly, the clouds roll by for you. Thank you.
Owen is one of our residents from Faith Center, and on behalf of all our poor, he has offered this tribute, so we thank him very much. We now call on Father John Barwa, who has come all the way from India to represent the Diocese of Rourkela, from where Brother Suresh comes, and the Bishop. And along with him is Father Thomas Ba'a. So we invite both of our priests from India. So let us give them a very warm welcome.
Dear sisters and brothers, good morning. First and foremost, we would like to appreciate and thank sincerely for your love and concern. And you invited us to be here on this great and gracious moment. As we arrived at the airport of Kingston, we were received with a VIP treatment. We were given a special reception, and we gratefully acknowledge your hospitality and gratefully thank you, our beloved people, and especially the brothers, missionaries of the poor in Jamaica. We represent Diocese of Rourkela in Orissa in India, which has 175,000 Catholics We represent also all the priests and religious of the Diocese of Rourkela. We represent the family members of martyr brother Suresh Barwa. We represent Bishop of our diocese, Most Reverend Alphonse Bilung SVD. Brother Suresh Barwa came from a parish called Junmur, and Father Thomas is the parish priest there. His father Chamru and mother Felicia, they have 4 sons and 1 daughter, and Suresh was the eldest among them. Father is yet to be baptized, and though family was not a practicing like this coming to the church family, it never blocked Suresh to grow in holiness, to grow in the love of God. He always longed to be a good boy, a missionary, where it requires challenges. Though we have many congregations in Orissa itself, like us SVDs, Jesuits, Salesians, he wanted to be a missionary, and he found his vocation rightly in the congregation of the missionaries of the poor. He, with his hard work, sincerity and creativity, Brother Suresh was loved by everyone in the parish, in the village. He was a hard-working boy. He was a sincere and prayerful, simple boy. And we heard yesterday, he continued his hard, these qualities of hard-working, sincerity and simplicity ever, always. My dear sisters and brothers, the Diocese of Rourkela alone has 30 members in this congregation, and we are extremely glad. One of our brother, Martyr Suresh Barwa, is chosen by God to be his precious flower in his altar, heavenly altar. Today, the local church in Rourkela, Orissa, and the tribal church has the highest number of vocations to religious life. And wherever we go in the world, we find boys and girls, religious missionaries from this locality, and we are grateful to God. We are not new to this martyrdom. In our locality, a few years ago, 2 priests and a brother were killed. And today that particular place has become a holy place, a sacred place, a place of pilgrimage. And hundreds, thousands come to pray. So also, few years ago, another priest, Father Arul Dos, coming from Brother Jesus' place, was killed, but not with gun, but with arrow and bow. Today, that place where Father Arul Dos was killed has become a pilgrimage place, and the church in Orissa is growing in faith, in vitality, in creativity. And we believe martyrdom of Brother Suresh will bring new hope, strength to face the new challenges. Because after the beatification of Mother Teresa in Rome, we had also a local celebration in our town, little town, the beatification of Mother Teresa. And Though we are very little number, small number of Catholics in the town, it was organized by the municipality, the local civil administration. And the first thing we did in that celebration was we honored a man who had donated 89 times blood. Blood for the life of others, that they are healed and they continue living. And we honored him. But today, Brother Suresh, Brother Marco, they have not given 89 times, they have not given 100 times, but they have given last drop of their blood, like Jesus himself. Today, especially the church in Orissa, and particularly the church in Rourkela Diocese, with our Bishop, Most Reverend Alphonse Bilung SVD, we are proud to send more missionaries to the whole world to proclaim the good news. As we came to this great land of Jamaica, we visited different centers of missionaries of the poor, and we found, true to their name, missionaries of the poor, and they are for the poor. And we really appreciate, brothers, and we pray to God that your apostolate, your commitment and convictions, your love for the poor will grow, ever grow. And we assure you, Rourkela Diocese in Orissa, in India, with 30 members in your congregations to send more missionaries, and communion in prayers and with prayers. Let the hard work, commitment, and dedication of Brother Martyr Suresh Barwa and Marco remain as a model to all of us missionaries. May God bless every one of us, especially the beloved land of Jamaica. God bless you. Thank you.
Tributes from Father Barwa.
Thank you very much, Father John and Father Thomas.
India.
We now call on Father Holong and friends, Winton Williams and Courtney, to please come forward as they offer their tribute in the song, My Son, My Son. Let us welcome them.
My son, you must go into the world. You must lay down your life. You must suffer. You must die. Let the world learn to love. Learn to sacrifice their flesh. You must give your life to sinners. On today, I love you, dearest son. You are my one begotten son. I love you from eternity. You die so they may live. I love you, my beloved child, my one and only son. Please save my people, lest they perish in hell. Father and God, I will go into the world. I will lay down my life. I will suffer. I will die. I will teach them to love and to sacrifice their flesh. I will give my life for sinners unto death. I love you from
The outstanding tributes and a special service of thanksgiving for the life of Brother Shiris Bauer and Marco Candelero Las Puñal.
And now we call our novice master, Reverend Father Ambrose Kulandai Raj, to come forward to give his tribute. Let us welcome him.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Brother Suresh and Brother Marco were always leaders in their own right. Suresh was the first child for his parents. He was the first to become a Christian in his family and a Catholic. He was always a leader when he was at school, and he continued to be a leader when he joined religious life. Suresh, among the youngest of our novices, one of the first year novice, was always on the front line, not by obligation, but by choice. He wanted to lead from the front by his example. Born and grew up in a Hindu family in Orissa, India, Suresh always admired and wanted to be a Christian and a Catholic. He always mingled with Christian friends, and when the time came for him to make his choice, he chose to be a Christian, a Catholic. Then his sister and the other two brothers followed his lead. At school, Suresh was a natural leader. His charm and confidence naturally drew others to follow him. He could have used this gift for his own ends, but wanted to put it in God's service when he entered religious life in the Missionaries of the Poor. Sometimes this gift, as you know, can cause some difficulty when you live with others. But Suresh, someone who never shied away from challenges, soon found a way of integrating his forwardness and his leadership with patience and appreciation for others' gifts. And so, he continued to be a leader among his peers. What I remember most of Samuel, or Suresh, Samuel, he came to be known as Samuel in the community, was his readiness to do anything for God and for others. And he always did this with a smile. Brother Marco, the older of the two, was one of the senior novices in our community. He was also a leader, although in a different way from Suresh. Marco always liked to lead others by example of his humility and service and simplicity. He was not as outgoing as Suresh was. Nevertheless, Marco's character and his humility and simplicity was hard to resist. He was a natural leader by example, extremely gifted with music, as you know, I think it runs in the family, extremely gifted with music and song. Marco could have used this to build a great future for himself. But his greatest joy was to see others happy. Father Fidelis, who is present with us here for this celebration from the Philippines, related to us how Marco, who was already serving God as a catechist, came up to Father Fidelis one day and said, "Father, I want to serve God with my life." And Father Fidelis said to him, "But you're already serving God in the church as a catechist." But Marco's response was, "I want to give God my life completely, entirely." What better way to do this than consecrated life, said Father Fidelis, and sent him to the Missionaries of the Poor. Marco, when he came to the Missionaries of the Poor, continued to give his gift of music and song. As many of you by now have heard, Marco's one of his last service to the community was a farewell song he wrote to one of our brothers heading off to Africa that same evening when Marco himself had to bid farewell to us. Marco always took pleasure in putting himself at the service of others. Though he was extremely gifted with music, Marco did not restrict his service to his talents, but was ready to do anything that was needed to be done. Both Suresh and Marco came to Jamaica to serve the poorest of our people, the homeless, the destitute, those whom even our own people have cast away. They came to do this freely and joyfully with the spirituality of Missionaries of the Poor, which is joyful service united with Christ on the cross. These two men, they served our people willingly and joyfully and desired to lay down their lives for them. They were leaders when they lived, they became leaders in their death. They were the first Missionaries of the Poor to shed their blood for Christ, for the church, for MOP, for the poorest, most especially for our island Jamaica. They are our first martyrs. They were leaders in life, they have now become leaders in death as they continue to build our community and our church and our people in God's kingdom. Suresh and Marco desired consecrated life as their goal. Though they never took vows, now they have been consecrated in blood. This is the greatest witness, greatest consecration any of us could desire. My brothers and sisters, we cannot give fitting tribute to Suresh and Marco, two young novices who have shed their blood for being witnesses to Christ and to the faith. And so the tribute that we will now like to give to them is in the lives of these young brothers who continue with greater resolve to serve our people, with greater joy to offer their service to God and to humanity. And so I'm now going to invite our novices, the community where Suresh and Marco lived when they were here in Jamaica and where they died. I invite them now to come forward and pay tribute to their fellow colleagues who are now in heaven joining us in this celebration.
Thank you, Father Ambrose. We now have the final tribute, a song by the novices, Here I Am. And we're asking all our novices to please come forward to take their positions.
In the gathering today at the Holy Trinity Cathedral, the leader of the opposition, Mr. Bruce Cowling, the chief of staff of the Jamaica Defense Force, Rear Admiral Hardley Lewin, Mr. Robert Pickersgill, Mr. Bernard Charles, Mr. Delroy Chuck. There are many members of the Catholic fraternity. There are indeed members of the religious congregation of life in Jamaica, all assembled here. In tribute to these two who served the poor in Jamaica, in the missionaries' mission here. This is their tribute.
By the bright sunrise,
open arms I come for warmth, to reach out your love, abiding in your word, embracing thy holy word, shouting in joy, here I am, here I am, O Lord, come and bend the knee, here I
celebrant in the Mass will be the Most Reverend Lawrence A. Burke, S.J., the Archbishop of Kingston, for the liturgical celebration in thanksgiving for the life of two martyrs, Brother Suresh Bawa and Brother Marco Candelaria-Lespunio, missionaries of the poor.
Dear brothers and sisters, we will now spend a few moments of silence to prepare for the Mass.
The concelebrants will be the Most Reverend Adjutant R. Clark, Archbishop Emeritus of Kingston, the Most Reverend Charles DeFore, the Bishop of Montego Bay, the Most Reverend Gordon Bennett, the Bishop of Mandeville, priests of the Missionaries of the Poor, and the Archdiocese of Kingston, and the Diocese of Montego Bay, and the Diocese of Mandeville, visiting priests from India and the Philippines, the homilist, the Very Reverend Father Richard Holong, Missionary of the Poor. The Master of Ceremonies is the Very Reverend Father Kenneth Richards, who also is the host pastor of the Holy Trinity Cathedral in Kingston.
The deacons of the Mass, Deacon Oswald Tye, Deacon Trevor Graham, are the deacons of the Archdiocese of Kingston. Music provided Mr. Winton Williams and Mr. Clive Hunter, the organists, and the choir, the Missionaries of the Poor, Father Richard Olong and Friends, and the Archdiocesan Choir. The entrance hymn, Enter Into Jerusalem. There will be greetings, of course. This is the entrance hymn. The Most Reverend Lawrence A. Burke will bring greetings.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Praise be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies, and the God of all consolation. He comforts us in all our afflictions, and thus enables to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we received from him.
Where's the holy water?
The cathedral is filled to capacity, and the congregation is housed outside in tents to the eastern side of the cathedral.
I bless the bodies of our brothers Suresh and Marco with holy water, calls their baptism, of which St. Paul writes, all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were buried together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. On the day of their baptism, our brothers Suresh and Marco put on Christ. Yeah. May thee be glory. Let us now continue our hymn, Enter into Jerusalem.
Enter into Jerusalem, let us go to God's house. Let us go to God's house. Enter into Jerusalem. Let us go to God's house. Let us go to God's house. We can celebrate. We can celebrate. We can celebrate. Oh Israel. Make we walk down there. Enter into Jerusalem. Make we walk down there. We speak to the priest and the gatherers of peace. Make we walk down there. We can celebrate. We can celebrate. We can celebrate. Oh Israel. Papa and your mama with your uncle and your aunt. Let us go to God's house. Enter into Jerusalem. Let us go to God's house. Come around across the bridge with a gathering of peace. Let us go to God's house. We can celebrate. We can celebrate. We can celebrate. Oh Israel. Let us go to God's house. The healthy and the sick, the worker and the weak. Let us go to God's house. Enter into Jerusalem.
summer, let us go to God's house. When we can win the gathering peace, let us go to God's house. We can celebrate, we can celebrate, we can celebrate.
The ceremony of the Paschal candle. Behold the light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
As long as the day lasts, I must carry out the work of the one who sent me. The night will soon be here when no one can work. I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he dies, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this?
Yes, we believe that Jesus is the Son of God, the Son of God, and Jesus is the Son of God.
Our life is hidden now with Christ in God. When Christ, our life, appears, then we shall appear with him in glory. If we have died with Christ, we believe that we are also to live with him. You raise up the Lord, will raise up brothers Suresh and Mark and us, along with Jesus, and place us in his presence. We know that Christ, once raised from the dead, will never die again. Death has no power over him. We know also that our own death is the beginning of our participation in the victory of Christ. We believe that God is faithful to his covenant. He'll give us the fullness of life on the last day.
The ceremony of the Paschal candle, led by Reverend Charles DeFore.
All-powerful God, we pray for our brothers Suresh and Marco, who responded to the call of Christ and pursued wholeheartedly the ways of perfect love. Grant that they may rejoice on that day when your glory will be revealed in its company with all their brothers and sisters, and share forever the happiness of your kingdom. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. The opening prayer led by the Most Reverend Lawrence Burke, Archbishop of Kingston. Continue with this special presentation, the liturgical celebration in thanksgiving for the life of two brothers of the poor, the reading now from the Word
of Wisdom, chapter 3, verses 1 to 9. God accepted them as a holocaust. The souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God. No torment shall ever touch them. In the eyes of the unwise, they did appear to die. Their going looked like a disaster. They're leaving us like annihilation, but they are in peace. If they experienced punishment as men see it, their hope was rich with immortality. Slight was their affliction, great will their blessings be. God has put them to the test and proved them worthy to be with him. He has tested them like gold in a furnace and accepted them as a holocaust. When the time comes for his visitation, they will shine out.